Now this is again your type 3. Let's try to solve it. It says that a man invested a sum of money at compound interest. It amounted to rupees 2420, that is 2420 in 2 years, and to rupees 2662 in 3 years. Find the sum. So this is similar to what we had done in the previous question. So compound interest for the first 2 years is this much, and in the for the 3 years it is going to be 2662. So again, the principal value, which we don't know, becomes 2420 in 2 years, and with one more year from here, that is after 3 years from here, this becomes 2662, right? So now what you are going to do is you are going to use the difference between these two. So if you subtract 2420 from 2662, you are going to get your answer as 242. Right, 242 is the answer that you have gotten over here. So now you would find out the rate of interest. So rate of interest for the final year, that is this particular third year, will be applicable on this sum 2420, right? So again, 242 is x percentage of 2420. This would give you the interest rate, that is this R over here. So again, you can write the same process for x is equal to 242 by 2420 into 100. This will give your rate of interest as 10%. Right? So 10% is the rate of interest that we have obtained now. But the question is asking, find the sum. So basically, the principal value is not known to us, and that has to be found out. Right? You also know that this principal sum in 2 years with this rate of interest, now we know that 10% is the rate of interest for 2 years, became 2420. This is the process that we know, right? And we already know in one of the previous questions that we have done that what is going to be the effective percentage value if you do it for multiple years, especially 2 years, a plus b plus ab by 100, right? This is what you do for effective rate. You know that this is 10% over here. So you will find out the effective percentage value for these 10 plus 10 plus 10 into 10 over 100, right? So this 10 into 10 is 100. This cancels this out. This becomes 1. 10 plus 10 plus 1 gives you 21. So 21% is the effective percentage rate of interest, which should be acting on this initial sum P, and that is going to give you in 2 years this 2420, right? Since we are using the effective percentage rate, this 2 years gets applied only once, right? So now this sum 2420, which was your amount value after 2 years, it was principal plus interest. Principal, you know, that is always 100% as per our assumption in the percentage method. Interest effective percentage is 21%. So if you apply or add these two, as you have done in one of the questions as well, this is 100% value, this is 21% value. Amount value is given to you. So this 100 plus 21, that is 121%, that is your amount value, is 2420. This is known to you, right? And all you have to find out is the final sum, that is the 100% value. So if 121% corresponds to 2420, 100% would correspond to how much? This is the final equation that you have to solve to get the answer. So in order to solve that, you will do a cross multiplication, and you are going to get your answer as 2420 divided by 121 into 100, right? So if you solve it, you know that this gets cancelled out over here. You are going to get your answer as rupees 2000. So 2000, which was invested, becomes 2420 in 2 years and 2662 in 3 years with rate of interest as 10%, which we had also calculated, right? So this is going to be the process.
If you like my lecture, please subscribe to my channel. You can also provide me feedback in the comment section so that I can make the required changes and improve the quality of videos as well as the content. You can also join my Facebook group as well as my Facebook page, where I provide regular updates as well as regular PDFs and test on a daily basis. I have Telegram channel as well as Telegram group also. You can join those also. There I provide regular PDFs as well as regular tests. The name of Facebook and Telegram groups and channels is Success RBI or Success SBI. There's a mobile app also. The name of the app is Infinity. You can join that app, you can download that app, and that will allow you to take quizzes just like you take a quiz in the real scenario when you go and take the examination, the government examinations. So that will help you get a better idea and take regular quizzes of phase one for RBI as well as SBI.